My name is Aileen, and I am an illustrator, comic book artist, graphic designer, and motion graphics animator. I first got into art as soon as I was able to pick up a crayon, and I just didn't stop, no matter how much my teachers asked me to pay attention in class. Cartoons, characters, stories, like all of my art is essentially just a sort of filter, a sort of pathway to telling stories, really. So I just kept story writing, but with pictures. What I love about doing art and being able to tell my stories through my art is, well, it's the fact that I'm capable of doing it. It's the fact that all of the little ideas in my head I'm able to just spat out onto paper, and then other people are able to enjoy them as much as I do. It's fun to be able to share those kind of things. I got into comics accidentally. I was sort of telling my stories through my art, and then I realized, well, on cartoons, they do more than just one picture. They're usually traveling or moving. So that's when I ended up doing one picture and then another picture and another picture. And it's like, oh, well, they'll probably also be talking. So I added speech bubbles, but they were just like walls of text that had no coherence. And I sort of just like stumbled into it almost organically, almost. I went to a store and realized, oh, somebody figured this out already. And I started going from there. With my comics in the future, I hope to be the same sort of influence on other people as artists have been on to me. So being able to, once again, tell my stories, but having those stories mean something to people. They don't necessarily have to mean the same thing to them as they do to me, but the idea of having somebody hold one of my books in their hands and reread it like I do with some of my favorite comic books, or even just tell their friends about it, just liking it enough to be thinking about the things that I have created and caring about it, is a terrifying but also exciting idea in my head. With my comics, I mean, I want my audience to feel, a lot of times I want them to laugh. Even if I haven't made a joke, it doesn't matter to me. I kind of like whatever kind of joy I can bring to people. I always try to bring a little bit of comedy in everything that I do, but if it makes somebody smile one way or another, that makes me happy. A lot of people try to say like, oh, I really want my work to make people think. You don't have to think if you don't want to. You can just be like, ooh, pretty colors, and I'll be fine. For commissions, I really like doing character art. I really like doing illustration and stuff like that. I have done a few short comic commissions in the past, and sometimes short little animations, just a little buzz of something for people. For Dungeons and Dragons, I mean, it's just another extension of doing character art. It's just, there happens to be some context that I already have. And it's really satisfying, once again, because a lot of times people approach me and they're already so committed deeply to this character, and they'll just have like a full essay to write up, and I'm just like, okay, yep, feed it to me, and let's go. Seeing the reactions of people after I've made art for that I've made something, and that just brings them such a light of joy, is wild with everything I do, even beyond art. But the fact that it's art just brings it up that whole new level. There's a lot of people who want to have their visions put into life. So when somebody comes up to me like, hey, could you draw this for me? I get to ask questions like, do you want this? Do you want that? Even though there's not really a problem to solve, it's kind of like problem solving for me, and being able to translate as accurately as I can the visual of what they wish for me. It's satisfying for me emotionally, mentally, and spiritually, I guess, as an artist.